I was a Peace Corps volunteer in Zaire from 1973 to 1975. And I did a third year as a Peace Corps volunteer in Cameroon. And there were about 112 of us, and we were going to eastern Zaire for our training. The pilot came on and said, oh, we're not going to refuel in Nairobi, we're going to Entebbe. And this was the time of Idi Amin, and bodies were floating down the Nile, and it was a very, very dark period in Uganda's history. While we were taxiing out, we could actually see the motorcade of Idi Amin arriving at the airport. They had taken our luggage off and gone through it. The contention was that we were mercenaries on our way to help the rebels in the Burundi. And the proof was we had a uniform because everyone had at least one pair of blue jeans on top of their luggage. Number two, we had books and maps in French. And number three, there must be a lot of guns because there were a lot of gun cleaners. These were our tampons, of course, and we had counted them out. 2 years worth. But anyway, in the end, it all worked out. And we all finally got to our destination in eastern Zaire. My first assignment was at a very, very, very remote mission school. Fathers had sent their girls away to this school because there were few boys in the neighborhood and they would be less likely to get pregnant and not finish school. But the problem for the girls was they knew that if they did finish high school, the bride price would go up so high that they would have trouble getting married. So there's a lot of sort of self-sabotage. The girls were not allowed to visit the teachers' houses, so I had like my little house with no visitors. It was too isolated, so I got agreement from the Peace Corps management to let me find another assignment. So I found a secondary school, which was a mixed school with boys and girls. The president's area was the northern part, the Equateur province, and he always would try to prefer the students from Equateur. And they took points away from the Bandundu students and added points to the students from Equateur province, which was a real shame because I had some really great students there. It was an interesting time in that the government was consolidating power by kicking out a lot of the foreigners. They had this program called Authenticité, or Authenticity, and they were nationalizing a lot of the shops that were owned by foreign nationals and handed them over basically to cronies. They ran them down very quickly. The economy started to really deteriorate. But it was a tough time, and Mobutu, the president of Zaire at the time, was very, very corrupt, and basically people had given up. Mobutu himself, even in front of a crowd at the stadium, said, Ibana Mayere, which means steal cleverly. The physical infrastructure was very lacking, there weren't roads. People still, even now, transport a lot of goods by river. It was a very basic type of existence for most people. Peace Corps directed the rest of my life, though. I went and I did my master's degree in African Studies and International Relations. Went to the World Health Organization in Geneva for 4 years on a secondment from WHO, and now in Department of International Health. So I've never left the international world. And going back to Uganda the first time, I was a little bit hesitating, a little bit worried about what I would find, but it's a totally different place now. I sometimes get a little impatient with my students who want to have an international career, but they don't want to spend any time on the ground. They want to go straight to Geneva. Unless you've actually spent the time in the field, seeing how life is lived on a dollar a day, you can't really credibly make a claim to be able to advise a government on what programs they should put forward for people. So I can really recommend it as an experience.